Hello, this is David King. I just want to show you a little experiment that I've created recently that I call Can Draw. You can play with it on draw.udavid.com. And this is just a little drawing canvas in the style of Khan Academy. What I'm really looking at is, can I record a video within the browser? So just all in JavaScript without using QuickTime and so on and so forth. And the answer is yes you can. And I'm standing on the shoulders of giants here. So I've got WebRTC.js and VideoConverter.js. So WebRTC allows you to access different video and audio streams. So the video stream here would be this canvas element that I will draw on. And the audio will be the microphone. And VideoConverter.js, so that's a port of Ffmpeg, which then allows you to convert both of those streams, merge them together. So you've got a single MP4 file, which has your video and audio over the top. So I'll show you it in action, and then I'll explain what happens. So I'll just click record, I'll count down. And so if I want to show what is 12 divided by 3, the answer is 4, and I'll click stop. So this will just quickly merge the videos here. It's usually pretty quick for a short video like that. Here we go, and that'll open up. So if I want to show what is 12 divided by 3, the answer is 4, and I'll click stop. Okay, so that's pretty straightforward. If I right-click that, I can just do save the video as, save that to the desktop. And so a lot of this output down here is really to do with the FFmpeg output. Because they've ported it directly from a command line tool, you still get all that sort of terminal style output down here, which is pretty interesting. I mean, you can access and use this just like a normal command line. So you can see here, the command that I send to it is convert the video.webm, which comes from WebRTC, which is this canvas, and audio.wav, which I've captured on the microphone. And I'm just saying merge them together. Don't do any sort of special processing, because I'm saying use the same codecs, combine it together, and just output a WebM file. So I'm pretty happy with that. It took me only a few hours to make this. Most of that was just sort of reading and about these new technologies and libraries. So yeah, like I say, just if you want to have a play, go to draw.udavid.com and have a tinker. I'm currently using Chrome Canary for this. It will work on Chrome, but there have been a few little hiccups and issues, which I think are actually sort of due to be resolved and rolled out in fairly upcoming versions of Chrome, but certainly Chrome Canary, there are no problems. And the reason that's a good way to go if you're looking at cutting edge technologies is Canary tends to be a very good predictor of what's going to come into Chrome. So you can sort of get a head start by playing in Canary, knowing that by the time it's released into the mainstream on Chrome, you've already got a sort of solid bedrock of knowledge. So I'm just going to leave it at that, and like I say, just have a tinker on the site here, and definitely look into those technologies. They are fabulous.